SCAN, also known as the Greater Richmond Stop Child Abuse Now, is a great resource here in our community. Their mission is to protect children and strengthen families.
They're hosting their 7th annual Race to Protect Children 5K Run and Walk on May 2nd, and you're invited. Executive Director of SCAN, Janine Harper, is here along with 5K participant, Lindsay Martin. Good morning, ladies. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning.
Good to see you all again. You've got a big event coming up, and we're going to get to the event in just a moment, but let's talk about SCAN for just a moment. I said there a second ago, it's obviously to prevent child abuse and strengthen families. How does that tie together? How does that work?
Yeah, well, you know, we have 5 programs across the Richmond area, and all of them are designed to either prevent child abuse and neglect from not happening in the first place through awareness, through training professionals and parents in terms of what's good parenting and what to look for when something might be happening. But also, we also serve almost 2,000 adults and children last year through our treatment and advocacy program. So when it has occurred, what can we then do to help that child and that family heal?
And Lindsay, you come to this event because of a personal experience. Can you share your story with us?
Yes, ma'am. My son Andrew was shaken by his babysitter at 4.5 months old. He is doing incredibly well now. We are actually going to be celebrating his 2nd birthday on the race date this year, so we're excited to celebrate him in that way.
He thinks it's his birthday party.
He actually does, and his birthday party is going to be right after it, so he's right on there. But he is family. Mark your calendars because I haven't let everyone know that. But, so we're excited to participate. We had so much fun doing it last year. We enter a team called Andrew's Army and really enjoy supporting this cause.
And you guys apparently made a lot of money for the event last year.
We did. Janine was reminding me that we've raised over $6,000, and we're excited. I don't know if we're going to, but we're excited to participate and to support this cause in any way we can. Not only do they help children and families who have been through an abusive situation, but they also help with advocacy, prevention, education of law enforcement, and prosecuting these types of cases.
So really covering the gamut.
Let's talk about Stop Child Abuse. Have you had success in actually stopping child abuse?
Oh, absolutely. You know, as Lindsay said, the more the community knows, and the more that every adult knows about, you know, what is child abuse and neglect, and how, what to do if you do in fact think it's occurring, and then most importantly, as a parent or any other caregiver, what are those tools, education, skills you need to help raise a, you know, a healthy, happy child, because that really is everyone's hope. So we absolutely stop it through education, through support, through education, and through treatment.
Yeah, parenting is difficult. It's a hard thing to do, and your organization also offers the tools that are available for parents so that they can get through this without turning to anger and violence and beyond, unfortunately.
Absolutely. We offer groups that, you know, because a lot of times it's knowing that you're not alone. Social support is a significant part of the prevention of child abuse and neglect. And then beyond that is giving people concrete information that they can then use. You know, they can go home and try that and then come back and get feedback on whether that worked or not. And so really making sure that people understand that parenting is wonderful and joyful and the best thing, but at the same time it can be very challenging. So reaching out for help, we always say, is the sign of a good parent, not a bad one.
There's got to be some comfort in that. I mean, anybody that's been a parent and dealt with children on a day-to-day basis, everybody reaches that point where you think you're going to lose it. Mm-hmm. And obviously the trick is to know that there's somebody out there that can say, this is normal, mm-hmm. this happens, now here's how you deal with it.
Absolutely. Normalizing the experience, because people do feel like they're alone. You think, only my child does this, or only I have this feeling of frustration or anger. And so when you know this is normal, you know, we all want to know something is normal. And so when we can help parents understand that, and then more importantly, to then say, here's what you can do instead. And that's really the key piece.
Well, folks can help do that through coming out and participating in your event, helping celebrate your son's birthday, and helping you raise some more money. Janine Harper and Lindsay Martin, thanks so much for joining us today. The Greater Richmond SCAN's 7th annual Race to Protect Children event is Saturday, May 2nd at the West Broad Village in Short Pump. The 1 mile kids run starts at 8:30. The 5K run walk begins at 9. We'll put complete details on WTVR.com/VTM.